Kingfisher's chief executive, Ian Cheshire, joins us from the London Stock Exchange. A very good morning to you, Mr. Cheshire. You're one of the few retailers which appear to be doing pretty well at the moment, despite the headwinds and prophecies of economic doom. I suppose it's cheaper to do it up your home than get somebody else to do it.
Yeah, I think we've seen our market actually, you know, despite some weakness in the UK, it's been pretty positive in France and actually very positive in other geographies. The further east you go, the more buoyant it's been. So our market's probably a bit more resilient, say, than consumer electronics. But really, we've seen a 24% profit increase in the first half off the back, mostly of actually our self-help, so if you like, our DIY inside the business by all the teams.
And there certainly seems to have been something of a turnaround in France.
Well, the French market was positive in the first half. It was nearly 3% growth, and we outperformed it, both businesses. But it's really pleasing to see Castorama and Brico Dépôt having a really good first half and making the most of slightly better conditions. Not great markets, but slightly better.
And how challenging is it going to be here in the UK over the next 6 to 12 months?
Well, I think we've seen a flat to slightly down market. We've said for some time we were cautious about the total market. What's probably more important for us is what can we do in a flat market, and we've been able to gain share. We've taken up some stores from Focus when it went out of business, and we're looking to expand Screwfix, and we're creating jobs in the UK. So despite the not very positive market backdrop, we think there's a lot more we can be doing in the UK, and we're pretty positive about it.
Tell me more about your expansion into Russia. What is it about that country that makes it an attractive target for you?
Well, there are basically three things going on in Russia. Firstly, you've got an emerging market in some senses. This is still organized retail is fairly early stages. There's a massive undersupply of retail. You've got 140 million people, many of whom are owning property for the first time, which is probably not in great condition given that it was in collective ownership. No one really spent any money on it. And finally, they do have a DIY culture. They're very hands-on, a bit like the Polish customers that we're very familiar with. And those three things together make for a great market dynamic. And I was in Moscow this Monday, and it confirms we've got some great expansion opportunities.
And does this mean a very heavy now capital expenditure outlay to finance this expenditure? Expansion, excuse me.
Well, we announced on Monday we've signed a further 9 stores, which will be 115 million. That probably takes care of the next couple of years. But we've got a balance sheet that's in extremely strong shape, and we've repaid nearly over £1.5 billion of debt in the last 3.5 years. So we've got the financial flexibility, and we can afford to invest in these growth markets, which is great for our mid and long-term future.
And how easy is it to do business in some of these growth markets? Let's take the example of Russia. How do you approach going into business there? Is it through joint ventures? Do you see other opportunities? What is it?
Well, we've taken a country-by-country approach. In Turkey, for example, we've got a fantastic joint venture with the Koç Group, one of Turkey's biggest businesses, bigger than Kingfisher, and that's been the right way to do Turkey. In Russia, we've gone ourselves because we couldn't really find a national partner because we're in 11 cities all over Russia, and we wanted to basically control it and go our own way. There's a number of different models, and we're pretty flexible country-by-country as to what's the right solution.